Tara Jacobson, marketing artfully. Okay, real quick, I wanted to make you a video about how to check your Etsy or Shopify stats in your Google Analytics. So first off, you got to hook it to Google Analytics. There's directions. I have links to how to do both in here, but they're hooked to there. Now, just so you know, I have not been a good Pinterest user for my Etsy store or my Shopify store, but I am working on it. And so a lot of times what I'll do is I write a blog post like this to tell myself what to do. So you can already see here, I have been promoting my Shopify store more on Pinterest, and I have gone from zero to six, seven. Those are hits a day. And that will continue to go up. But the thing that's interesting, I just want to show you these because I do show you the data. And here you can see, and this is my glamorously vintage one where I have been posting more. And you can see immediate results where you're going from zero to one to three to three. Now, it may feel like three, like that's not worth it, but I've been literally doing this for 3 days. So if you were to do that longer, it would go up. And I'll show you that in my last account where I actually try to get Pinterest traffic. So here we're getting 41 hits a day, 45 hits a day, 40 hits a day. And as I have been trying to increase that, it's been going up. Imagine that. So the interesting thing about this is how you can look at these stats and see what is going on in your Shopify or Etsy store. So this is my Etsy store. So I had 3,775 sessions last month, last rolling month, last 30 days to my Etsy store, and Pinterest sent 1137 of those. So that's excellent. That's very nice. And you can see that's going up while my stats from Etsy are maintaining the same. Or so if I didn't have that Pinterest shop traffic, they would be going down after the first of the year. We're in March now, so that would have been February, March, and this may not be the best time in the world to be an Etsy seller, but I can help generate my own traffic. So this will show you where they're coming to. So the Poshmark sheet is doing really well. These are my landing pages, so these are my products. You'll be able to see what your products are that are doing well, and then you'll be able to see which pins are doing the best. So looking at this, if we were to say, I wonder what pin this is, I would be willing to bet it's a Poshmark pin, right? So let's see what it is. Yep, Poshmark listing sheet. And this was saved by Etsy, so this is really nice. I originally saved it on one of my boards, and then Etsy picked it up, and they posted it to their site. And I didn't do even a very good job of it. All I did was I pushed publish, or I pushed share from the Etsy site, and it pulled in this whole thing, which I wouldn't normally do that. I would normally be a little bit more thoughtful about it, but I guess it doesn't matter. Okay, and this is my next best pin, and let's see what this is. Sorry, I have a weak hold. I think my son gave it to me. So this is another Poshmark pin, so they saved it a different time. Each of those is an instance, and let's see what this one is, 44. Okay, and let's see where this goes. It's thinking, thinking, thinking. Okay, and so this is a real estate business planner. And then you can see in Pinterest how many impressions you've got. It's gotten saved 18 times. I have promoted this pin in the past, so that could be part of it. But this analytics report, this is the Christy Hill free, where you can see what pins, like it just automatically made this thing. So I will put a link to it so you can add this to your Google Analytics for your shops. But see, this is saying that the Smart Loop has sent me 24 hits this month to my Etsy store. And I would guess that that's probably to that, real estate planner. And that I'm doing that in my Tailwind. So that's where Tailwind, which is a different service, everything up till now is totally free, but Tailwind has a monthly fee. But you can even do Tailwind looping and Tailwind tribes. I know tribes are free. I think you can do a few loops for free too, where you could put some of your, like I would watch this data and then put some of your best pins or put some of your best products into those loops so they stay active in Pinterest. So hopefully that helps. Tara Jacobson, Marketing Earthly.